What's up guys, I'm Sherman. Today let's talk about riding gear and accessories. Welcome back guys, hope you're doing well and being safe. It has been a rough few weeks in Sri Lanka because of the lockdown and I'm waiting eagerly till it's safe to travel again. So in this video, I'll be talking about all my riding gear as well as the accessories I use for motorcycle travel. And there's also a giveaway for y'all, so stick around till the end of the video to find out how you could take part in it. Let's dig in. Having a good helmet for long distance riding is very important, and we have chosen the Scorpion ADX1 helmets for us. And this is jam packed with features and it's really, really worth it for the price. So the shell is made out of thermoplastic resin and it's very quiet, and also the chin curtain helps to reduce the noise. I think this is one of the quietest helmets that I've used, and reducing the noise inside the helmet really helps to reduce the fatigue and it helps to protect your hearing as well. So the next feature we have on this helmet is the two wear vents, one on the top and one on the chin. This really helps to keep the air flowing inside the helmet and keep it cool. And there's also an exhaust vent in the back. This helps to take out all the hot air inside the helmet. One of the most key features of this helmet is that it's a modular helmet, and it's very hard to find a helmet at this price range which has a peak and is a modular helmet which you can raise off your chin bar. And this really helps you when you're traveling. There are two other modes you can use this helmet in. You can dismount the visor to switch to a perfect off-road use with goggles, and you can take off the peak and use these two covers to transform the helmet into a street helmet. This comes with a SpeedWeave retractable sun visor, which is also UV400 approved. So the helmet comes with a pin lock system by MaxVision. What the pin lock system does is it stops the visor from getting fogged. Even though the temperatures inside the helmet and the outside different, still the visor won't get fogged. So it's really helpful when you are in cold weather or in the rain. And having clear vision is very important when you're doing long distance traveling. Or whenever you're on the bike, it's nice to have clear vision, so pin lock really helps. So next we have our intercom system. This is the Cardo Freecom 4 Plus, and we got the dual pack, so me and my wife have one on each helmet. So this really helps us to communicate to each other, and we don't have to shout and scream when we are going fast on the road. We can connect it to our phone, so we can answer calls, make calls, listen to music, and you can also control the phone with voice commands. The sound quality in this is really good because it comes with JBL speakers, and it has this system where it adjusts its volume based on the ambient sound. So when you're going really fast and your throttle is open, you can hear clearly, and when you slow down also your music levels goes down, so you won't be blasting in your ears. When the battery life, it lasts about 10 to 13 hours, so a whole day of riding continuously you can use this without a charge, and you can charge it through a power bank, so it's no problem, and it's really nice to have and it's very convenient. I have the MBS Moto motorcycle jacket and the pants. The jacket is the MJ21 and the pants are the MP51. It's really important to have a good riding suit to prevent you from getting injured in an event of accident, and it really helps you to protect yourself from the elements. So this suit comes with CE approved armor on the back, the shoulders, the elbows and as well as the knees. And the outer shell is made out of 600D Cordua water resistant material, and the neoprene lining on the collars and the cuffs, it really makes it comfortable to use, and for long distance riding, comfort really matters. So one of the main reasons I chose this jacket is because of its air vents. It has two air vents in the front and one big exhaust in the back. So this helps the air to flow through the jacket and keep yourself cool. And riding in Sri Lanka, one of the biggest problems I face is the heat. So this really helps you to cool yourself and do more riding and enjoy the trip more. So the boots I use are the Speedmax motocross boots. These are really comfortable and gives me the extra grip when I'm doing off-roading. And it's also waterproof, so going through rain and going through water, it's really easy, and I won't have soggy socks in the end of the day. So it's really nice to have a good pair of boots. For gloves, I use the Icon Pursuit leather gloves, and these are not exactly adventure riding gloves, but I bought these during my cafe race days when I was riding the Classic 350. These gloves come with a knuckle arm, and the palm is protected with reinforced leather, and the leather is perforated so there is a lot of airflow, and it's really good for the hot weather in Sri Lanka. So next on the list is this little guy. This is a tire pressure monitor, and this has got me out of trouble so many times. And during my Kataragama trip, if you guys haven't seen the vlog, I'll link it up here. I was going through the Uddavalave National Sanctuary, and my tire blew off, and I had to push the bike about 2 kilometers. If I had this at that time, I would have known the tire pressure was going down and to take precautions, but at that time I didn't have it. So once I came back home, I did a lot of research and found out that this exists. So I got one right away, and this indicates the tire pressure as well as the heat. During the last trip, for instance, it was the opposite. Normally you get the alarm for the air pressure going down, but during the last trip the air pressure was going up because of the heat of the tire was too much. So I stopped the bike and reduced the air, and if I didn't have this, I'm sure the tire would have blown off and we would have met with a bad accident. So next, I have modified the Himalayan backrest with a customized back support as well as a larger rack, so that it's easy for me to mount my camera bag and strap it on, and also my wife enjoys the extra back support she gets and it's more comfortable for her. So next on the list is my luggage system. I have the Royal Enfield panniers as well as the GV tank bag and Vitara trail packs, and I have done a whole video about what I take and carry and how I pack stuff onto the motorcycle for long distance trips. You can check it out, the link is here. And next we'll talk about all the other accessories I have added to the bike. So there are a few more accessories I have added to the bike, and one of them is a handlebar brace. This gives the extra strength the handlebars need when I'm standing on the pegs and doing off-road riding. And next we have the knee grips on the side of the tank. This also helps me to grip the tank when I'm standing on the pegs and have more control when I'm doing off-road rides. Next, I have added new side mirrors for the Royal Enfield Himalayan because the stock mirrors aren't that great. So I have put new side mirrors and added these blind spot mirrors for a wider view. So I have also fixed a lighter charger so that I can charge any of my devices on the go, and this is mostly for emergencies because I use the power bank most of the time. So that's it, that's all the gear and accessories I use for motorcycle travel. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you have any suggestions for future videos, please put it in the comments below. And also, if you haven't still subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. See you guys in the next video. Keep exploring and ride safe.